when I started the lab, I really wanted to make this a space where undergrads can work. Lynne actually was one of the first undergrad students to join the lab. We were still a brand new lab. I had just hired a postdoc. I had hired a junior specialist. I was starting to look into graduate students. So it was a very first sort of phase of trying to put a team together. When Lynne approached me, she was just really interested in doing research. And she had individual project ideas and a knowledge of the general area of our work that really impressed me. In our lab, we are really interested in plant natural products, so small chemicals that are produced by plants for their various purposes.
Many of our products that we use come from plants. So necessarily, in order to understand these different products and how we use them and any new ones that we can make, we first have to understand the biochemistry and how plants use these different compounds to produce different things that, you know, we enjoy and need. The amazing, masterful chemistry that plants have available to them, given to them through millions of years of evolution, and understanding that. And while it may seem very daunting at first, it has inspired me quite a bit to delve deep into how plants actually work.
Lynne has been prolific in publishing, which I think is unusual for an undergrad student. So we published 4 papers together. And on each and every one of them, Lynne had a really important role. In one, for example, we identified together the first enzyme that realizes the really most crucial reaction in the production of a compound called sulvinarine A that is produced in the trivial name for the plant is diviner sage. It's a very strong psychoactive plant. There are clinical studies right now that show that this compound could actually be a replacement for morphine, a compound that acts on the same receptor but doesn't have any addictive properties. So for us, hugely interesting. And so Lynne was involved in actually identifying this first enzyme, and that was a really great publication that eventually led to some of her own fellowships in continued work on that.
Support for research is necessary for every function of a lab. Without funding, there isn't any science that gets done. The wonderful generosity of donors and funding sources allows us to contribute to the amazing variety of different products available and a different understanding on a fundamental level of how plants function and how biology works. The Zerbe Lab has just been like a wonderful door of opportunities for a variety of different skills that I'll need as a scientist. I really aspire to combine science and debate, communication, and arguing, persuasion, kind of applying science in that way in order to kind of shape society in a way that allows for the production of science and for us to appreciate science.